So I wanted to find a method of smoothing my 3D models without using acetone. So I did a little bit of research and I think I've found the perfect method. Stick around to see how you can smooth your 3D prints. Okay, so here we have the Darth Vader melted mask from one of my previous videos. You can check that out from the link in the description below or from the little eye up in the top right hand corner. What you'll notice is that the lines aren't very smooth at all and they're very prominent. So what we'll do is we'll grab the little plastic container and our Z-Poxy PT-39 resin. Now I'm going to eyeball it here and we'll pour some into the plastic container. And as you can see there, that's the clear resin, ready to go. Now the next step is we need to add the hardener to complete the epoxy. So once again, I'm eyeballing it here and there's the hardener. Now I've sped up this footage, but this is me mixing in the hardener and the resin together so they react. Now you can see that the mixture is very cloudy and it will eventually go clear once it goes onto the model itself. So what we'll do is we'll grab our trusty paintbrush and start applying the Z-Poxy to our Darth Vader melted mask model. Let's start the time-lapse footage. Okay, so while I'm applying the epoxy here, I'll tell you a little bit about the product. So it's from a company called Zap, and the exact name of the product is Z-Poxy PT-39, and it's quoted as being a 30-minute solution. So to me though, I would definitely leave it for 12 hours because I just don't see it setting anytime sooner than that. Now this is a good alternative to acetone smoothing, as well as another product out there called XTC 3D from a company called Smooth-On. I picked this particular one up off of eBay and I paid about $31 Australian, and you can find this overseas as well. So if you're living in the US or Canada, you'll be able to purchase this product as well. I'll just pop a picture of the box up on the screen so you can see it. And there it is. This is the very first time I've used the product as well, so what you're seeing here is my first attempt, and I think it really shows, for a beginner at least anyway, how a first attempt could actually turn out. Now with a little bit more practice, I know I can get a better job of this in the future, so for everyone watching, don't judge me on this, this is just my first time. So after all that rambling, let's have a look and see what the final product actually looks like after it's been sitting for about 12 hours. So after all that awesome time-lapse footage, here we go. Now you'll see it's really nice and smooth and all those ugly lines from before are all gone. Awesome. Now this was my first time using the Z-Poxy solution, so I ran into a few issues and I thought I'd discuss them in like a top 10 countdown things not to do. So here we go. Number 10. Make sure you do this in a well-ventilated area, because even though it says that there's no odors, it does get quite fumey. So make sure you are definitely in a well-ventilated area. Number 9. Okay, so these two things here are your most important things. So no matter what, wear gloves. This stuff is an epoxy, so it's just like super glue and it will stick to your hands. So whatever you do, just make sure you wear gloves. Number 8. Make sure you have the right tools for the job. So in this case, make sure you've got the right size brushes for the right size application. In this example, I would have used a finer brush for the more intricate details inside the model, whereas on the outside, I would have used probably a slightly bigger brush. Number 7. Make sure you've got some isopropyl alcohol handy for rinsing your brushes and the container as well, because it will stick to it, and if you don't get rid of it, it'll just be a lumpy mess. Number 6. If you don't want your 3D model to stick to your desk or table after you apply the Z-Poxy solution, I'd make sure you put something underneath it, like a placemat or some baking paper. Number 5. Now, whatever you do, don't pick up your model for at least, I would say, 12 hours. I did mine in the first hour or two, and I did leave some fingerprints on the model itself. You can see it right here, and even though it doesn't really detract from it much, I think that it looks a little bit unprofessional. Number four. One of the things it does say on the Z-Poxy bottles is to make sure that you puncture the top of the bottle. What I did instead is I chopped 3 millimeters off the top, and now I find the solution comes out a lot easier. Before it was like a really, really thick syrup that was just so hard to squeeze out. Now it just pours out. Number three. One of the other things that I should have done is attach the model to some sort of stand with double-sided tape or a blue tack. Now, the reason I should have done this is because when you get to the edges, it gets really hard to apply it smoothly. And also, if you put it on paper, that's what it looks like. Number two. Now, this is definitely something to look out for. Next time when I was doing something like this, with all the intricate spaces in here, I would start here first instead of starting on the outside. Reason being is that you can get into all the fine places without having to worry about moving the model too much. And you can also tip it up on its side, hold it there. No problems whatsoever. You can see into the crevices a lot better. Whereas if you do the outside first, all this stuff in here is a lot harder to get to, which is what I found. So starting here first, ending here. Number one. So this is probably one of the most important tips that I've got for you. When you get to your 3D model, try not to lather it on too thick. If you have a look around his mouth, he looks like a drooling bulldog. Now, while that looks cool, it's not the effect that I was going for this model. So next time I would just put it on not thick, but not too thin either. Well, that's it for another episode of 3D Burn. I really hope you enjoyed it. If you did, give me a big thumbs up and maybe even leave me a comment down below. If you do enjoy the content that I'm providing, please make sure you subscribe as it really helps me a lot. And as always, imagine, learn, create. Bye!